impossible to stop as we for sure on the road. Stay to myself, stay off the medium, chilling, they gon' play with the trolls. Going 100 in the I-8, I pray to God we don't lose control. No, I'm on a paper chase, my little whip on cruise control.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Today, we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Carolina Panthers. Season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Right off the bat and a first down. Plays like that will really help this offense settle in here on the road.
And when you go on the road, you also have to deal with the fans as well. And when you have those types of runs, that'll settle them back into their seats.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. They toss it down to Pollard. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. See the athleticism there of Brian Burns stopping him behind the line.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
Prescott. And this is going to be incomplete. You look at this Carolina defense. Well, they've been very good this year against the pass, currently holding on to a top 10 ranking at number 10.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. There's Prescott. Out of his hands quickly to CeeDee Lamb. And to the 46 he goes, and no further. So he is well short of the first down marker. That'll give him 8 that time. And it'll be fourth down. On fourth down, Matt Araiza sent on to punt. Back deep to return is K.J. Hamler. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. Start on the ground here at Sanders. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Well, that run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through, pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, "We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going."
Got it.
Operating from the 27 now. Here's second and three. Dotson in motion right. Now Young fakes a sweep and looks to throw off play action. Going to be caught downfield by Dotson. A big play there for Carolina. 41 yards.
I guess we got a good idea about what the game plan is for Dak in the secondary. No beating around the bush with this crew. His first throw of the game is a deep shot, and it connects. That's a tendency breaker right there, because normally you build up to the big shot, but not in this case.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Up the middle they go with Sanders. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. The Panthers at 4-5, a game under 500. And Charles, they were losers last time out. What do you think they need to do differently here?
Well, I don't think it needs to be as drastic as burning up last week's game tape or not watching it, but the attitude has to be what's done is done. Let's move on. Put that one behind them. Galvanize it.
And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Micah Parsons, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
That's a ball he needs to let go of there. Wasn't the most time in the world to work through his progression, but NFL quarterbacks, they've got to sense the pressure. They've got that internal clock, and the ball has to be gone. And if you're not going to escape and run for it, you have to let it go before the pressure gets to you and puts you on the ground.
That throw by Young, incomplete.
It's pretty early in the game, but they've already tried to establish him not just as a runner, but as a receiver as well. Didn't happen there, but I wouldn't be surprised at all to see them try again shortly.
This is up and good from Pinheiro. The Panthers stay claimed to a 3-0 lead. So pretty good opening drive. That'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted six, but they got three in the early lead.
And they should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope that good things are in store here today for them.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And they dipped a game below 500 following the loss last week. And you get the sense that maybe this team's at a little bit of a crossroads here.
Yeah, I think that's a really good way to put it, because what's that old malaprop? If you come to a fork in the road, take it. Because this crew, they're losing ground fast. They've got to start winning some ball games. And the good teams, they're starting to separate themselves, and these guys are being left behind.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. You look at this Carolina defense. They've been very good this year against the pass, currently holding on to a top 10 ranking at number 10.
And I'm struggling a little bit trying to really categorize this crew. They're top 10 in the league against the pass, but the bottom half of the league in sacking the quarterback. That doesn't make sense. Imagine if this crew ever put pressure on the QB, they'd easily move into the top 5.
His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down. Prescott now from the 50. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there. That one winds up incomplete.
Offense is moving a little bit, having back on their heels, but they're on a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
A second down throw for Prescott. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And this, Charles, definitely not what they were wanting to see. Remember, he threw 3 interceptions in the loss last week, and now he gives the ball away again here in the very first quarter.
And you have to think that this was drilled into him all week, too, by his teammates, by his coaching staff. They've told him all week long, we've got to protect the football. They've probably crossed that fine line with giving him the right advice and saying it too much. And it turned out that it got into his head a little bit.
That'll go for a gain of 7, and it's second down. Clock running, under a minute to go now here in a fast-moving first quarter.
Dak rep.
Second down, Young. Going right back to Dotson. And the Panthers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made without the foul.
And remember, this drive started out following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Now a throw in the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
Young now. And that's complete to Sanders. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. Three nothing after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Charlotte, and it's the Panthers with the football as they'll see what they can do on third and goal.
Ready. Here's yellow.
Young working out of the gun. Dancing to his left. And I think the ball's out. And this is going to kick out of bounds. Boy, a fortunate bouncer too there. They'll keep possession back inside the 10-yard line. So Young will head to the sideline, and on is Pinheiro for the Panther field goal. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. The kick by Pinheiro is good. Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for them.
You're exactly right about that. And this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to want to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Pushing his way through. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And a good pickup there. He gets about 6 up to midfield.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Second down and 4. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Complete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down.
Out of the gun to give to Pollard.
Yeah, he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down.
But this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. Here's Prescott. Flushed out right. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line.
Fourth down, no problem. Just a ho-hum pickup of 14 to keep the offense on the field. So the drive will indeed continue. First and 10 at the 35-yard line. Now Prescott. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
A second down throw for Prescott. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
But it looked like it marched to the end zone. Is it a momentary roadblock with that incompletion? No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
On third down, it's Pollard. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. It's a 7-yard run, but it does bring up fourth down.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and they are on the board, trailing now 6-3.
So, Charles, they are on the board after that kick. So, 3 drives, 3 points. Obviously not the start that you were hoping for, but they're able to erase that zero off the scoreboard.
Yeah, I guess what you're saying is a point of drive is not what offenses are striving for by any stretch. They're happy they've got 3 now. They hope that that unlocks their offense for bigger points down the road.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
On second down, Young again. Incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender. Couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Young on third down. And he is caught, and they work this well up here across the 45. 23 yards, the final tally. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. And he goes down, but not before getting his inside the 25. A big run there, 29 yards of the first. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On play action, Young. A throw left sideline falls incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. A third field goal of the first half, not what they're looking for as they come up on third down. Young to throw it. Diving catch. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Young to throw.
so many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
To throw on second down is Young. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Daquan Jones fighting his way home to get the sack.
Are you seeing what I'm seeing? That's three sacks now, and this team came into the game in the bottom five in the league in sacks.
Yeah, this
What's
is
going
not,
on?
It's not been their bread and butter. I don't know, is a blind squirrel finding a nut, or is this something they can build on?
Well, they found some momentum. They found a crack in that offensive line, and they're putting it to good use.
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Hayden Hurst, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers add six to their lead. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, called it the 26. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Pollard will take it up the gut. And he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up second and 4.
Looking to throw. Prescott. Swinging this out for Pollard. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Prescott now. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play, and it'll be second down. Prescott to throw it. Flush to his right. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
So roughing the passer penalty and an automatic first down.
And that's the mark of a bad team, partner, because that's an easily preventable penalty, but they just didn't take the proper steps to make it so.
On first and 10, Prescott escaping the pressure right. And this is caught at the 8. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And his kick is indeed good. And they will cut the lead back down to a touchdown now at 13-6. So, yes, they'll still be down going into intermission, but the deficit is now made even smaller, very manageable.
Yeah, and if nothing haywire happens here in his last couple of precious seconds, they will go into the locker room with a nice bounce in their step, having gotten a little bit closer on the scoreboard.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, it didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it. But I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities. And I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That second down play nets a minus four.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now Young. Looking for Thielen, but it's intercepted. Inside the 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Now the extra point try forthcoming. It's right through, and we are now tied at 13. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for
nowhere to go here. He lost the football, but fortunately he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. We always hear a lot of veterans on the defensive side of the football. They talk about smelling blood in the water, putting pressure on a rookie. They got to him there to force it free, but couldn't recover it.
And you mentioned the pressure. Rookie quarterback, you're going to bring more pressure to him at all times because you don't know how he's going to hold up. He was fortunate there. Luck was on his side, able to recover that fumble.
Ready? On second down, Young. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback, because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Young will set to throw. That one downfield for Dotson. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs.
They'll take over first down 10 at their own 31-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. There he goes, left side. He may go. Touchdown, Cowboys. Tony Pollard, his seventh rushing touchdown of the year. And the Cowboys have scored again in this third quarter, this time to move out in front. Point after try forthcoming. And they will take a 7-point lead now.
Makes the score Cowboys 20, Panthers 13.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. And this will come out to the 25 as Hamler elects not to return it. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Ed Wynn told me once, you know, we're having a tough patch. This too shall pass, this too shall pass. And if I would keep having a rough patch, he said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. 70 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Another run with Sanders. And he'll work down inside the 45.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
And they'll come up second and 7.
Check peek. Ready?
A give running left. It's Sanders. Calling a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 5. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Young. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on 3rd down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on 3rd down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on 4th and 5. From the shotgun, it's Young. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down. And they come up with a big one there to keep the drive moving and then some.
Ultra. Hurry.
They go back to the ground with Sanders. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. Saw the linebacker Damone Clark coming through with a stop. 3rd quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a 2nd and 10. Gets this out quickly to Dotson. Touchdown! Jahan Dotson. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are an extra point away from drawing level. And oh, he missed it. No good. And they'll remain down by a point. So we're back to a 1-point game now as the kickoff comes. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
2nd down, Prescott. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll be out right at the 35. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz game, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Now Prescott. On the out route, it's Lamb with a grab. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
A gain of 15. First down, Dallas.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. But we'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. To throw is Prescott. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Going to take a shot for Gallup. Oh, he had a man running free, but he overshot him, and it's incomplete. This offense so far on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is going to be third and 13. On play action, Prescott. And that is incomplete. Critical play in this football game. As if they pick up the first here, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them because they know that they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. And he's going to get this down inside the 40 before he's finally ridden out of bounds. A big play there for Carolina. 41 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Sanders toss left side. He's brought down in the red zone at the 18 after a gain of 18. First and 10.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Watch out now. 50 Fury.
Right back to Sanders on first down. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Let's go.
Here now, second and 4.
Ready?
Now Young running the option left. And he held on to it, but he probably shouldn't have as they get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Young. Oh, he had him. He was was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
But the passing game right now for them, not overly impressive. Last week, he hit on right at 50%. This week, he's under 50%.
And it's not just on him. Protection, a few breakdowns along the way that's made him get off the spot. Receivers not getting their way open downfield. The coverage has been awfully tight. They've got to all get together and find ways to make this passing game get in gear.
This is up and good from Junior. And they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. A first down throw for Prescott. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
Oh, this defense knows. Fourth quarter, they need to make the play. That one was right for the taking. Could have changed the complexion of the ball game, but it winds up incomplete.
Now a second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Caleb Farley. And it's a huge return as he brings us all the way back down to the 15-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They'll run. It's Sanders. Oh, no, he lost the football. Could have been a costly mistake, but as it turns out, they keep possession.
You can't give away these types of opportunities in the red zone. And I'm sure that was flashing through his brain as the ball escaped his hands. Fortunately for him, able to get picked up by his team, fumble recovered. They still have an opportunity deep in the red zone.
Here we go.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. They go play action. Young. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he is going to lose yardage here. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. Third and 7 now.
And that's a great job of tackling right there. If he could have made the first man miss, maybe he could have taken it into the end zone. Instead, they stopped him pretty well right in his tracks. And you often see that in the red zone. Offense has to be quick. In this case, the defense was quicker.
Young on third down. Forced out to his left. And a nice job there defensively to contain him and get him to the ground a few yards short of the first down marker.
Well, he was looking at a dime formation, six defensive backs on the field. So he's looking for anyone to throw the football to. But he didn't have anyone open, so he took off and ran for it. But he came up just short, and that brings up fourth down.
A big one coming for kicker Eddie Pinheiro.
This to at least make it a 5-point cushion. The kick by Pinheiro is good. For that one as that drive ends in three. So they get the three, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down.
They'll come up first and 10 here. To throw, Prescott. Oh, and that is incomplete.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
Now Dak. Complete. Pollard.
Sometimes it's hard to figure, but you can live with incompletions in this situation. You can't live with these short gains that take time off the clock.
You know who loves it? This defense. Big play looming here. This is 3rd and 7 with a crowd on their feet. Now Prescott. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout.
And I believe the referee's been buzzed. Yeah, they want to take another look at this call. And it's certainly a big one here late in a tight game. So the folks in New York just going to wind up confirming what the official saw as this play will stand as is. Prescott. And he will find his big tight end over the middle.
Brandon's okay what they're doing right now. Still able to work the middle of the field, but you know sooner or later, they're going to have to stop the clock.
All three timeouts still at their disposal. Here's 1st and 10 now. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. Able to push his way through. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. Here's 1st and 10. Here's Dak. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
Here's Prescott. Able to hit his target land. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. And in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Here's Prescott. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away, live to fight another day.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle, got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him, all focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same.
And he's across for the touchdown, and it's likely the game winner here in the closing stages. Charles, that drive was perfect, methodical, executed so well, and they grabbed that lead with almost no time left for a last gasp from the other side.
No way you could have drawn up a better final drive, because not only did they keep their eyes on the end zone, they made sure they bled the clock out as well and denied their opponent a chance to respond. That's just terrific situational football to end this one.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
And just shedding him off there.
And he returns this to the 22.
This is first and 10. One last shot for Young. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner. Although on that last play, they were so backed up, it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded, because we've seen the improbable.
Yeah, if I did it, then I did it right. Yeah, this ain't happened for me overnight. Yeah, bet against me, you gon' pay the price. Yeah, down to business, I ain't playing nice. Yeah, so ahead of y'all, I'm out of sight. Yeah, when you pop it, they don't wanna slice. Yeah, greed and envy, that's a part of life. Yeah, mediocre, that just don't suffice. Better now than ever. Ain't no cracking under pressure. The boy is clever. If I did it, it was stellar. Nobody fresher. Stop complaining, man, my head hurts. These catchy records. Ain't nothing really but a walk in the park for me. Heard the catalog, you know I got some scars on me. Just getting started, you don't really want to start with me. It's John Q, I would sacrifice a heart in me. For family, high roller. But you wouldn't know it by the way that I rode up. If I did it, then I did it right. This ain't happened for me overnight. Bet against me, you gon' pay the price. Down to business, I ain't playing nice. So ahead of y'all, I'm out of sight. Yeah. When you poppin', they don't wanna slice. Yeah. Greed and envy, that's a part of life. Yeah. Mediocre, that just won't suffice. Keep myself grounded, that's a piece of me that I won't let go. No matter what level I reach, I promise to hold it close. Ain't gotta tell me this hitting different, man, I already know. How are you claiming we had a baby we ain't never spoke? I don't be out here with random women on the road. They want a DNA test to prove it, I'm like, here you go. I could've saved you a bunch of time and told you the results. Looking for hush money from me, you ain't gon' get it though. Historic, rain on my parade, I keep walking and ignore it. Part of the game, yeah, it comes with the territory. It's just another day, man, I'm used to it downpouring. It's nothing. If I did it, then I did it right. This ain't happened for me overnight. Bet against me, you gon' pay the price. Down to business, I ain't playing nice. So ahead of y'all, I'm out of sight. When you poppin', they don't wanna slice. Introduction. Ooh. Style my own can, no one touch it. Ooh. Became what they said I couldn't. Ooh. Mediocre, that won't cut it. Life is a gift, I wanna live it to the